Hi friends, welcome back to this React.js Advanced Concept series. In the last video, I have explained about useEffect hook in depth. In this video, I'm going to talk about useRef in depth. Let's start. useRef hook is commonly used for accessing DOM elements directly. Let me show you an example quickly. Here I have a text box and a button. On clicking this button, I need to focus this text box. For that, let me create a ref using useRef. And I can connect this ref to my input box like this. Now inside this focus input function, let me put a console log. If I click this button, I am getting a current object. Let me console log this current object. Now I am getting the input element itself. So to focus this input box, I can use the inbuilt focus function like this. Now if I click, we can see the input box is getting focused. Like this way, we can access any DOM elements directly using useRef. Let me show you one more example. On clicking this button, let me also change this button font color. For that, let me create a new ref and connect that with the button. Now inside this function, I can access the button element and change the color using the style property, like this. Let me test this. Okay, good. Okay, let me show you another common use of useRef. Here I have a login form where I have a field for username and another field for password and a button. If there is a requirement to show this value anywhere in the screen, maybe like this, I can use a state, and when I change this input field, I can update the state, and while sending this value to backend, I can get it from the state. But usually in login form like this, there may not be a requirement to show this value anywhere. So we should not follow this state approach, because if I add an useEffect, we can understand for every keystroke there is a re-render, which is not needed here. So instead, we can use useRef to avoid this re-render. First, let me comment this state, this input change function. useEffect. And this div, which we are not going to show. Okay, now let me create two useRefs, one for username and another for password. Let me connect these with the respective DOM elements. Now let me add a click event to this button. And let me print these values inside this function. If I test now, we can see we are able to get the values from the text box. We can pass these values directly to backend without storing in any of the state. Okay, before we close, let me show you one more concept. Here I have a current character state variable, and I have a text box to change this current character. But I also want to store the previous character when a new character is entered. For that, if I create a new state and once this current character is changed, if I push the current character into the previous character array, it won't work. That is because when I change the character, this setCurrentCharacter state is called, which will trigger a re-render. And so in this useEffect, only the current character is pushed. And inside this, we are setting the previous character state, which will trigger another re-render, and so we can see the current character only, not the previous character. We can address this using useRef. Let me show you. Instead of state, let me create a ref. Now we don't want to do all these. Instead, let me push the current character into the previous character. And here, let me use previous character.current. Now, when this current character state is set, the new character will be pushed into the previous character. But it won't trigger re-render, and so we will see this previous character instead of current character here. This way, we can achieve our requirement. Hope you understood. That's all for today. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.